Hey house guests, welcome to today's Big Brother 18 updates and spoilers. Our house guest today is Robin Sunderland. Thank you so much for your support. You're awesome, and I hope you're enjoying this season as it winds down. Hopefully there's still gonna be some more interesting stuff, right? If you guys want to be house guests today, check out our Patreon link in the info box below. We still got spots left. All right, so the other night James was talking to Michelle and he was all, Natalie's pulling away from me. So he was saying he's gonna let her come to him. He's not gonna be chasing her around anymore. And what do you know? James settles into a bumper car for a nap. Let me just note, James is not a have-not, but he chose to nap in one of the bumper cars. So Natalie goes in there and she gets in the car with him. She's like all snuggled up to him. She's holding his hand. So I don't know if she like sensed that James was getting worried or what, but he had to be loving that. So they had a little game chat, and I would not want to go in those bumper cars after hearing about Zakiya and Polly. But anyway, they have a game chat, and these two are still thinking that Michelle is staying this week. And James also thinks that it's going to be a double eviction. I think that's a little bit more believable, but I cannot believe that they think that Michelle is staying. I mean, all signs are pointing to no. Come on. But he's also saying, like, I think I might be the second one leaving during double eviction. He's already packed his things. Natalie packed her things this morning, but, like, don't worry about that right now. So, I mean, we've got people packing who aren't even nominated this week. But they agree, like, Michelle's gonna need to pull through and win this HOH for them. She's not gonna be here. And Natalie says if she wins HOH, she's gonna put up Victor and Corey. Now, here's the thing, like, do you guys think when they see that Paul is staying, are they going to go after Paul and Victor? Or would they go after Nicole and Corey? I think that they would target Nicole and Corey, and Paul and Victor are just going to, like, whoop, stay in the shadows. It's going to be nice for them. So James, Natalie, and Michelle were in the bathroom, and Michelle's like, so James, have you talked to Nicole and Corey about the votes yet? Because he said he was going to do that. And James is like, nope, I realize I don't need to, you know, I feel really good about it. My gut is 99.999999% sure that you're staying. He's gotta get that gut checked because something's off balance in there. His gut has not been reliable at all this week. He's been wrong about pretty much everything this week, so yeah, you need to stop listening to your gut. But Michelle's like, okay, well, if you're not talking to them, then I don't need to either. So then Natalie is encouraging her, like, no, you should go talk to them. Jamesy, don't you think that Michelle should go talk to them? And James is like, well, it wouldn't hurt. So then James is like, honestly, though, Nicole and Corey are not going to blindside me. They did not tell me that you're going, and I'm a lot closer to those two than you think. So they're like, oh, really? So yeah, he's pretty confident that Michelle's going to be staying, and he tells her, just chill out. Just relax. It's going to be fine. So then Nicole and Corey are upstairs trying to figure out what the hell they're going to do with this $5,000 bribe. It should not be this difficult, but they're having a hard time deciding. So apparently the diary room was putting a lot of pressure on Corey yesterday to decide. I'm thinking they want to include this in tonight's show because what else are they going to show? Michelle sleeping for 48 hours? No. So they called Corey into the diary room like 5 times, like, what are you going to do? What are you going to do? What are you going to do? So Corey's saying, like, it would be really lame if he just wasted it and, like, nobody got the $5,000. So they're going through the different options, and there were pretty much, like, 3 that he could do. He could give it to Nicole to break the tie and vote out Michelle. He could use it to get someone to drop out of the HOH competition, but, you know, they're thinking, what are the chances that somebody's actually going to take that bribe this late in the game? It's going to be a really important HOH, especially after Michelle is voted out, and the other side is like, what? And also, Corey is feeling really safe. He doesn't feel like he needs this HOH win, and he doesn't want to waste it on that. So then the third option, which I thought they had decided on a few days ago, but then they kept changing their minds, give it to Victor to vote out Michelle. So give Victor $5,000 to not vote out his best friend in the house. That's hilarious. But they agree, like, you know, it doesn't seem like Victor's going to be voting Paul out anyway. We don't want to look sketchy, make it look like we don't trust him. But Corey brings up it could be a good way to solidify their final four, kind of give it to Victor as, like, you know when on Mad Men, when they were trying to get business and they would, like, take out the new clients to lunch and they would, like, pay for everything and get really drunk? It's like that. They want to give him that assurance, like, look, I'm giving you this money. We want to work with you. Do this. So, I mean, it's a good idea, I guess, right? I mean, what else is he going to do with it? So then, they're a little worried, though, that James and Natalie are going to be pissed if they find out that they gave the bribe to Victor. So then Corey's back to, like, it would just be easiest to give it to Nicole. No blood on his hands, whatever. He would feel really good about giving that to her. And Nicole's like, but I don't want to look selfish. And I already won this and this and this. So anyway, Corey's like, all right, I'm going to give it to Victor then. So, like, every time it seems like he's made up his mind to give it to Victor, Nicole's like, Corey, wait, I don't know. Is this the best thing to do? So, I mean, they go back and forth for a long time. He finally buckles down and decides to use it on Victor. So he's like, number one, it's going to ensure that Michelle's going home. Everybody's going to feel good about that. Paul's going to feel more comfortable. Nicole can stop being paranoid. It's going to solidify the Final Four alliance. And Victor is going to be really grateful. And hopefully he will remember that in the future. And he won't use it against them. So Nicole kept saying, like, I want you to do something that's good for your game. And she feels like this will be better for Corey than just giving it to her. Because he's already got Nicole in his pocket. So meanwhile, we've got Michelle, James, and Natalie in the Tokyo room. And Michelle's like, do you think that I should talk to Corey? And they're like, yes. And then Michelle's like, well, I don't want to. So she's saying that Nicole and Corey haven't talked to her all week. Every time she walks into the room, they're just like. So then Michelle's saying Nicole is so freaking stubborn. There's nothing that she can do to change her mind. And she calls Nicole and Corey Tweedledee and Tweedledum. I mean, after this week, I think the same thing can be said about your alliance, but whatever. But Michelle admits she's just too proud to talk to those two. And that's really sad because she has made no effort this week to save herself. And it's just like, really? That's how you're going to go out? So she says that Nicole and Corey have already made up their minds and talking to them is not going to help. Like, she's not going to be able to convince them. You haven't even tried. But James starts agreeing with Michelle. He's just like, all right, in that case, don't bother. Whatever. Oh my God. All right. So then Nicole, Victor, and Paul are up in the HOH room. They're just talking about whatever. Corey is in the diary room being like, I'm going to use this bribe on Victor. So then he gets out of there. He goes up to the HOH room and he's all excited about what's about to happen. So he announces to the group, I've got some big news. Victor and Paul look like they're about to poo in their pants. They're just like, what's he going to say? So then Corey's like, Nicole and I want to solidify our Final Four deal with you. And he offers Victor the bribe to vote out Michelle. And Victor is so overcome with emotion. He starts tearing up. He cannot believe it. He's shaking. And he accepts the bribe. I mean, obviously he was going to vote out Michelle anyway, but he was very touched. Paul was all like, that's friendship right there. So, like, there were a lot of hugs all around. Everybody's hugging Victor. Everybody's hugging Corey. They have a group hug. Everybody's excited. Final Four forever. But for real, like, it was actually a really sweet moment. It was cool to see. So they all agree that they're going to keep the bribe a secret from the others. And they also agree that they're going to throw the HOH to Victor if possible. He's all, I'm going to put up James and Natalie. And I think he's going to do that. I feel like this four, they're actually planning on going to the Final Four together for now. I mean, you never know. We'll see what happens. It all depends. You know, if James or Natalie wins HOH, I'm sure they would be very quick to throw each other under the bus. But anyway, a little while later, Michelle notices that Paul's mood has changed. He's a lot happier now. You know, he's had a weight lifted off of his shoulders. So James and Natalie are like, well, Meech, why don't you go talk to Nicole and Corey and, like, find out what's going on, you know, scope it out. And she's like, no, they can come to me. That's not how it works. You're up on the block. You need to go talk to them. So then Michelle is saying, if I'm evicted, I'm gonna freaking blow up Nicole's game on the way out. what are you gonna call her, Snake again? Like, I'm not really sure what she's planning on saying, but I am intrigued. So then she's also saying if Nicole makes it to the final two, I'm never watching Big Brother again. I don't think they care. But she's saying Nicole and Corey have sticks up their butts. They've got Paul and Victor's heads up their butts. What else is up their butts? So she's telling James and Natalie, vote me out if that's what the others are doing, if you find out that that's what they're doing, because I don't want you guys to make yourselves targets. If Paul stays, he's gonna go after the people that voted him out. Yeah, I think it's too late for that. I think they're already targets, but anyway. Michelle is all, I'm not gonna talk to Nicole and Corey, but she's all for pushing James to do it for her. She's like, you know, would it really hurt for you to go and talk to them? And James is like, you gotta do this for yourself. I'm not doing it. Like, if you wanna find out, you need to go talk to them. Oh, snap. So it was more of the same for the rest of the night. James, Natalie, and Michelle were all hanging out. And then you've got Paul, Victor, Nicole, and Corey hanging out. Lots of Europe stories from Paul. They're all talking about traveling together, blah, blah, blah. Okay. Also, last night, Corey could not sleep because he's a have-not this week. And he's got a hard time getting into those bumper cars. So he actually cleaned a lot of the house last night. And everybody woke up and they were just like, what? Like, how did this happen? So today, the house guests were preparing for what they think will be a double eviction. As far as I know, it's not. Like, they didn't announce anything about it, so I don't think so. Unless it's a big surprise. I don't know. But James and Michelle were in the bathroom at one point, and James whispers to Michelle, I think you're going. And for a second, I was like, oh my god, did he finally wake up? So, like, there's this pause, and then he's like, just kidding. Oh my god. So Michelle's like, oh, I just really want to know. Like, I want to know what's going to happen. And yet, she still has not talked to Nicole or Corey about the votes. So a little while later, James, Natalie, and Michelle are all hanging out in the London room, and Michelle's saying it wouldn't make sense for the others to keep me because she's made it very clear that she's targeting Nicole. And if they're so cool with Victor, why would they vote out Paul? And James is like, oh, because they want Victor all to themselves. So ridiculous. So then Michelle's saying that she wants to dump baby powder at Paul, Victor, Corey, and Nicole on her way out if she's evicted. Wow. Poor sport much. I don't think she's actually going to do that. That would be really messed up. But it seems like Michelle knows deep down that she's going to be going tonight, but she's still, you know, got some hope because James and Natalie are still insisting that Michelle is staying. It's ridiculous. Natalie is also still trying to get Meech to talk to Nicole and Corey. Meech is still refusing. I don't see it happening. And as far as I know, Nicole and Corey are not going to tell anybody what's going down unless they ask. Like, I'm pretty sure I heard them have that discussion last night. So tonight's the eviction. Michelle is going. But the big question is, will it be a blindside? I don't think Michelle's going to be that shocked if she's evicted. Well, I mean, when she's evicted. But I think it could be a little bit shocking for James and Natalie. Also, expect a Michelle and Paul stage kiss during their eviction speeches. They were planning that out. And just a little side note, today on the CBS website, they gave a little bit more information about the fall season of Big Brother. Apparently, it's going to be called Big Brother Over the Top. It's going to premiere on September 28th, so like less than a week after this season's finale. Are they going to like redecorate? Is it going to be like one of those home improvement shows where they change everything up in like a few days? Or are they just going to clean that place up? I don't know. But it's looking like there's only going to be one show per week on Wednesday nights. And then, of course, the feeds. So it's going to be interesting. Let me know what you guys think in the comments about what's going on this season and what's going on with that Over the Top season. And until tomorrow, much love.